The most simple way is think of the brakes on a car, and that the ipilimumab binds to the brakes on an immune cell, a T cell. And by binding the brakes, it prevents them, and the car then is basically running away without the ability to turn off its motor or its immune response. That's kind of been the most simple way of thinking about it. There is some recent data that suggests the ipilimumab might also play a role in eliminating one of the subsets of cells that I spoke about that are immune suppressive, and that's the regulatory T cells. They do express CTLA-4 on their surface, and Alan Corman recently has shown that you do eliminate some of those as part of the treatment in animal models. So it's possible that it's not quite as simple, but most of us think of this brakes, loss of brakes, unregulated activation of the T cells, which leads to both the response and certainly some of the toxicity as well.